Hello, I'm Blake Ress, Commissioner of the Indiana High School Athletic Association. Today, I'd like to tell you about a friend to the more than 160,000 student-athletes in the state of Indiana, Farm Bureau Insurance. In their own low-key way, Farm Bureau Insurance has played a key role in the success of high school athletic programs throughout the state. Since joining the IHSAA as its exclusive corporate partner in 1988, Farm Bureau Insurance has contributed more than $3 million in support of high school student-athletes. On behalf of all the member schools of the IHSAA, we would like to take this opportunity to thank Farm Bureau Insurance for its support of our young people.
Today in Indianapolis, Kathleen Mills leads Lafayette Central Catholic in the Class A championship. For South Central, it's Brittany Shane. From Conseco Fieldhouse in downtown Indianapolis, it's the Class A state championship game, Lafayette Central Catholic and the South Central Rebels. Good morning and welcome inside Conseco Fieldhouse with Jane Schott. I'm Chris Denary, ready for a great day of state championship basketball. We have a good matchup here in Class A.
Absolutely. Two unranked teams who are defensive-oriented, so we're going to see a great basketball game today.
When we look at how these teams got here, first of all, we look at Lafayette Central Catholic. They come from the north. They knocked off three-time defending state champ Tri-Central in the LaPel Regional and then won a semi-state game last week. For South Central, they got here on the road and they won in Southport at the semi-state. They beat Attica last Saturday. Both of these teams have won eight consecutive games. Lafayette Central Catholic is 17-10. South Central is 23-5. When we come back, we'll have more. We'll hear from the coaches here at Conseco Fieldhouse. It's the Class A state championship game on the Indiana Cable Network. The IHSAA championships are brought to you by Ball State University, the nation's number one wireless college campus. And by Indiana Farm Bureau Insurance, a proud sponsor of the IHSAA. Welcome back to Conseco Fieldhouse in Indianapolis. It's game one of four today, our morning game, the Class A final, Lafayette Central Catholic and the Rebels of South Central. I'm Chris Denary, my partner is Jane Schott. We'll have all the telecasts for you today here on the Indiana Cable Network. This Class A matchup should be a good one. South Central 23-5, Lafayette Central Catholic 17-10. Earlier this week, my partner Jane Schott had a chance to talk to both coaches.
What do you have to do? You knocked off a couple of really tough teams here to get through the tournament. What do you have to do on Saturday to continue your run?
At this point in the game, just keep doing what we're doing. We've been rebounding the ball real well, playing good defense. Haven't ran a lot of gimmicks or zones. Just been the kids have been getting after them man-to-man, and I think we match up pretty well with South Central, so that's probably going to be the plan again. We'll just, whoever does that the best will win. So.
Very good. Well, good luck to you, Coach.
Thank you.
A chance to find out about Central Catholic, kind of an interesting matchup between the two of you unranked teams in the state championship.
No, I don't have a whole lot on them yet. That to me, they're a scary team because they look similar to us. Usually we're used to running into the teams with the big post players are a lot bigger than us, and they're similar to us. So this could be scary.
Well, good luck to you on Saturday.
All right, thank you.
All right, you've heard from both coaches. Now it's time to get ready for the game. South Central and Lafayette Central Catholic coming up next on the Indiana Cable Network. Welcome back to Conseco Fieldhouse. Chris Denary along with Jane Schott. Indiana Farm Bureau Insurance sponsors our starting lineups. Jane, clearly Lafayette Central Catholic will have to contend with Brittany Shane, the sophomore averaging 20.5 points a game.
Well, they're going to match up man-to-man, but they're going to put Grace Walker on her and try to slow Shane down. And they played solid defense all the way through. So Kathleen Mills in the middle, Katie Peachin, as well as Katie Rydell and Jenna Jones are going to shore up their defense to try to slow Shane down.
And when you look at the starting lineup there for LCC, Katie Peachin did not play as a sophomore. Head coach Jeff Salmon talked to her last year, did not play, said, hey, why don't you come out in the summer, have some fun, see if you like it. She liked it, and she's averaged 8.5 points, 5 rebounds, and 5 assists. And, Jane, she's a real reason why they're here today.
Big key to their success. You have a point guard that can run the show that allows those shooters to shoot and get the ball inside to Mills.
Lafayette Central Catholic representing the North, wearing the white, South Central in the Cardinal or the Maroon in the dark uniforms. And Lafayette Central Catholic wins the tip, and that's Peachin at the point. With the basketball, she had 14 points in the semi-state win in Plymouth over Argus last week. And an early foul called against Kayla Orwick for South Central. Now, Jane, both of these teams did not get a practice in here this week due to the circus and the Big Ten women's tournament. So the first time they came out to warm up, the first time they've been on this floor.
Yeah, they walked around for a while. You could see both the teams. The girls were a little starstruck because it's a big arena, and getting used to that might be a little difficult today.
Jeff Salmon watching his team. The missed shot by Mills. Got it back, put it up, missed it again. And South Central the rebound. Now they have their first opportunity with the ball. That's Brittany Shane, their leading scorer, up with the left hand. Missed it. And rebounded by Mills for LCC. So just underway here in Indianapolis, the first game of four today. This is the Class A state final, Lafayette Central Catholic and South Central.
See, the ball goes inside to Kathleen Mills almost every time down, and they'll try to contain her and kick it back out. That's what Central Catholic's going to do, and they've got some shooters on the outside. They've got to get used to this background, though.
Bad pass by LCC, and here comes South Central. That's Karen Deaton for three on the left wing. Well, that's a good way to start if you're South Central.
Well, I think so many people pay much attention to Brittany Shane. That'll leave some of the other South Central starters open. Karen Deaton, one of those starters. Orwick has already got a touch on the ball, and so that's obviously going to be a big key for the Rebels.
And absolutely, shooting in an environment like this, nice pass down low, but it's missed by Shane. And Mills has another rebound for Lafayette Central Catholic. Again, much different background than you're going to face in the high school ranks.
Yes, absolutely. I know Central Catholic went to Purdue to try to get a little bit of a feel in a big arena, as you see Kathleen Mills power it up inside.
She is LCC's leading scorer at 12.5 points a game, and now South Central will go again for three. Orwick misses. Rebounded by the Knights. And the Rebels tie him up.
Well, the one thing South Central plans to do is make this a full court game by pressuring all over the floor as much as they can. They usually play their 1-2-1 full court defense, and you see they've already caused 2 turnovers on Central Catholic trying to get down the floor.
South Central averages nearly 60 points a game, Lafayette Central Catholic at 52, and both teams good defensively. The Knights giving up just 44 points, South Central at 43. Here's another bomb taken by Deaton. Offensive rebound, and Shane now underneath gets her first two.
Well, Brittany Shane missed her first two shots. Maybe she was too close. She's a three-point specialist. And this is another thing that we're going to have to keep an eye on, Chris. I saw the South Central Attica game last weekend at the semi-state, and South Central was whistled for 15 fouls in the first half. They got into a little bit of foul trouble. Coach Shane had to go to his bench, and they still succeeded. They are very aggressive, and if the officials are going to call it tight, that could change the complexion of this game.
Sarah Peace has called for the foul for South Central. That's her first. The Rebels have two fouls, and Lafayette Central Catholic has gone to the bench, and Rachel Bishop is in, a 5'7 senior. She has the ball, but it's loose, and it's a jump ball. Possession error will belong to Lafayette Central Catholic. Bishop averaging 7 points a game off the bench. Again, Mills is their leader at 13 points. Very balanced scoring. Peachin at 8.5 points. Katie Riddell at 6.9. And Jenna Jones at 8.5. So it's not just Kathleen Mills inside, and a walking violation for Peachin.
LCC, 4 early turnovers already. Having trouble hanging onto the basketball.
And so South Central has the ball. They have an early 5-2 lead. Man-to-man defense by the Knights. Here's another three taken by South Central, short by Peace, and it's rebounded, but South Central gets it back. Orwick will fire again, this off the back of the iron. Nice offensive rebound put right back in by Valerie Burnett.
Valerie Burnett snuck in. Kathleen Mills did a nice job of checking out, but didn't get any help.
And South Central knocks the ball away, but clearly their full court pressure, the tempo that they have played, Jane, really putting a lot of pressure on Central Catholic.
Well, this is the way they've played all year long. When you look at their size, they're not very big.
So they're going to, off of a made shot, put a press, much pressure on, and you see right there, Valerie Burnett gets the shot to go in, so now her team can set that press.
Mills has it inside. Now they go right back inside to Mills, and Mills missed it, but gets her own rebound and lost it in the lane, and a loose ball, and South Central has it again. Ball knocked out by Peachin, and you can just see how quickly that head coach Randall Shane wants that basketball to get down the floor.
Yeah, they play up tempo. They're not going to power it inside. A lot of their inside shots will come off of back cuts or from offensive rebounds, as we've seen already here this morning, Chris. And because of their size disadvantage, they're going to keep the pressure going and on the offensive end try to push in transition.
Randall Shane is in his seventh year, 123-55. A year ago, they were 19-7. They lost to Northeast DuBois in the regional last year. This year they knocked off Northeast DuBois 49-46, then won the Southport semi-state last week, beating Attica 54-43. Had a history of coaching his sons in AAU basketball. Now he coaches his daughter Brittany for this South Central team. Jenna Kingsley is on the floor. She has the ball now for South Central as both teams have gone to the bench. Nice pass inside, and Sarah Peace has it for the Rebels.
Well, there's that back cut I was talking about, Chris. They run a flex offense, so they'll get a screen, and they'll get nice, easy looks at the basket if you don't cover that up.
Peaching up the floor quickly. Here's a jumper. It's off the mark by Grace Walker, and South Central runs again. Nice pass. And Jenna Kingsley scores, and it's all South Central right now. The Rebels out in front, 11-2.
Well, it causes Jeff Solomon to take a timeout because his team looks right now in disarray. They're taking quick shots on the offensive end, and so that means that South Central can get the rebound and get out and run, and that's an effect of their transition, as you see Pease right there with the easy shot.
Well, South Central comes in with 8 straight wins. They're 23-5, and they're unbeaten in their own class this year. In Class A, they are 18-0, and you can tell the tempo that Randall Shane wants to play, and they have turned it into sort of a helter-skelter game, and that's what he wants.
Absolutely. They'll trap all over the floor, and they will try to cause your ball handlers to feel uncomfortable and get out of your offense. And I saw them do it last weekend, and they're continuing what they've been doing all season long. Right now, Central Catholic needs to just settle down and take care of the basketball so they can get into their game, which is get it down and get it into Kathleen Mills.
9 of the 11 points have been created off Lafayette Central Catholic turnovers. Now full court pressure again. LCC gets it across the line. And Peachin out front. Mills catches. Riddell in the lane, takes the little jumper. It's off, rebounded by the Rebels and Karen Deaton. Looking for a double-figure lead, South Central. They go inside to Shane. She's cut off. Nice pass outside to Deaton. And now Sarah Yelch misses from the left side. And Peachin has the ball. They are making life tough on the point guard. Free throw line jumper. Everything is off right now for LCC. And South Central races up the floor.
Brittany Shane gets the ball in the return pass and tries to do something but ends up traveling.
All right, we have our first timeout of the first quarter, and South Central has the lead. They lead by 9 at 11-2 on the Indiana Cable Network. South Central has raced out to a 9-point first quarter lead over Lafayette Central Catholic, 11-2. You're watching the IHSAA Girls State Championships here on the Indiana Cable Network. We have a complete day for you. Coming up, we'll have the 2A final following this one. The 3A final at 6 o'clock. The 4A final will tip at around 8 o'clock tonight. Jane and I will have all four of the telecasts here. We'll introduce you to our sideline reporter, JMV, coming up here. He's patrolling the bench area. As Lafayette Central Catholic down early through the first 5 minutes, Jane, of the first quarter.
Well, you can tell at that timeout, Coach Jeff Salmon must have talked about moving the basketball. They're running a little flex offense as well, screening, trying to get some motion, and they've had the ball more in that offensive set, Chris, than I think maybe collectively they've had so far in this game. And you see Peachin get a nice little layup inside for LCC.
So it's 11-4 now. They put a little pressure on South Central. That's Shane out front. Sarah Peace has the ball. Peace at the point, averaging 5.5 points, 5 rebounds, and 5 assists. And a walking violation called on Jenna Kingsley. 5 different players have scored for the Rebels. 2 players for LCC, Peachin and Mills.
Big stat there is the 5 turnovers that the Knights have committed. South Central is sticking to their game plan to try to keep the pressure going.
Rebounds are even right now at 7. Riddell has it. 6 minutes nearly gone by. Here's a long three. Missed by Jenna Jones. Gets her own rebound.
And Jones is the three-point specialist for that team. Shoots 41%. Gets a lot of kickouts from Kathleen Mills. At that time, I thought she rushed the shot a little bit. She needs to be a little more patient so she can get a really good spot up, because that's when she's the most effective.
Grace Walker is back on the floor. And Pete, let's make that Riddell has gone to the bench. Yeah, Jenna Jones, 47 threes this year, 41% from behind the arc. She had 11.7 rebounds last weekend against Argus in the semi-state. Rebels have the ball. Brittany Shane drives right to the hoop and is fouled on the floor. That's something that LCC will have to be concerned about. Shane is a very effective three-point shooter at 36%. She's made 65 on the year. She likes to get to the hoop as well.
Yeah, she's not afraid. Very aggressive on the offensive end. And if she's got the open jump shot, she'll take it. But she is a quick first step off that dribble so she can get to the basket effectively as well.
South Central has the lead. 7 points here. Kayla Orwick, and we have a blocking foul, and it's called on Kathleen Mills in the lane, and Jeff Salmon not very happy about that call.
Well, that's one of those situations. That's her second foul, so that's a big foul for Central Catholic. As you see, Sarah Beth Reed come off the bench to replace Kathleen Mills to make sure she doesn't get her third. She, you know, Mills was just bumping the cutter, but the problem is she stepped up and brought her arms up, and anytime you do that with that kind of motion, the official's going to get you with the foul. You do want to bump the cutter through so that she doesn't go uncontested to get a pass, but at the same time, you got to keep your arms down.
She is their leading scorer, leading rebounder. She had 22.7 rebounds against Argus last week. Offensive rebound no good, and Peachin gets the rebound. Quickly ahead to Rachel Bishop. Nice pass to Reed and count it. So Sarah Beth Reed comes right in, Jane, and does what you'd like any bench player to do, participate and score early.
Absolutely. When you see this pass in transition, you know, Lafayette does a nice job of getting the ball down the floor. She stepped in, took a dribble to gather herself, and goes up strong. Not a tremendous amount of contact, but just enough to draw the foul.
Reed averages 2 points a game on the year. And she may have to play some real quality minutes now with Mills on the bench. Left-hander. And knocked out of bounds by South Central.
Central Catholic seems to be settling down a little bit on the offensive end, so we hope that this could turn out to be a good ball game in terms of being competitive.
Well, and if you're Jeff Salmon, you have to look. You've committed 6 turnovers leading to 9 points. You're shooting 27% from the field. You're only down 5. They're just sort of throwing the ball around. That's the 7th turnover now for Lafayette Central Catholic. Shane. Orwick. And a block. Nearly a nice play, but Sarah Yelch to the free throw line to shoot it twice. So free throws now for South Central.
Kayla Orwick making something happen there on that reversal pass. She drove into the baseline and drew the defense. You know, she has really stepped up her play. She was averaging about 5 points a game prior to the tournament and has stepped her scoring average up to around 9 in the tournament. So, you know, Coach Randy Shane has been pleased with that. Take a little pressure off of his daughter, Brittany Shane, and also give a little bit of help on the offensive end to their team. Karen Deaton averaging 9, but those are the only 2 scorers that have a decent average scoring.
Sarah Yelch off the bench. 4 points, four rebounds as a 70% free throw shooter. As a team, South Central at 68%. And both free throws good. Now full court pressure again. Another turnover and another hoop, and Orwick gets it.
Right now, it's been all South Central on the defensive end. They're just reading the passing lanes very well.
Bishop to the basket, draws the contact and the foul on Yelch. That will be her first. That will be the fourth team foul against South Central in the half, and Rachel Bishop to the free throw line to shoot it for Lafayette Central Catholic.
Well, the one thing, if you watch the way that South Central plays their press, you can go over the top of it. And if you don't, you're in trouble. And that's how they've picked up their turnovers, that they've resulted into points, getting some layups. Coach Randy Shane talked about that before the game. He was concerned that his three-point shooting might be a little bit down because of the background. So he's trying to get his kids to go get some layups. And you can see they're executing that very well.
Free throw was missed. It was short, nearly rebounded by Bishop, but we have a jump ball. And the possession arrow belongs to Lafayette Central Catholic. Again, if you're just tuning in, this is the Class A State Finals. Lafayette Central Catholic and South Central, both teams in their first state championship game. In fact, six of the eight teams today are newcomers to State Finals Saturday. And we'll have another jump ball. And this time it will belong to South Central. So the Rebels will have it. They jumped out to an early 9-point lead using an 8-0 run, and their full court pressure has been the story. They have forced 9 Lafayette Central Catholic turnovers, and LCC averages just 11 per game. Shane missed the shot, Peach in the rebound. And the Knights have the basketball. And a foul out front, and it's on Brittany Shane, and that will be her. Is that her first or her second? That'll be her first. So Brittany Shane picks up the foul. Jane, really, that's not where that's a cheap foul. You don't want to pick that up.
Katie Peachin was not really trying to go to the basket, and one of those fouls that you hate to see her get, and Coach Shane takes her out and has her gather herself, because you definitely don't want Brittany Shane, if you're South Central, you don't want her picking up her second before you get to the first quarter, into the first quarter.
So Shane has gone to the bench with one foul. She'll sit out the final 20 seconds of the quarter. Lafayette Central Catholic can work for the final shot. Bishop right to the basket, draws the foul. With 13 and 9/10 seconds to play.
Rachel Bishop making her way on the offensive end. She's known on this team as a defensive stopper. Usually Grace Walker will start out on the best player for the other team, and that's what's happened here this morning. Walker started out on Shane, but when she needs a break, Bishop comes in and she guards the best player. But right now, Rachel Bishop has been to the free throw line the last two trips down for the Knights.
Sarah Pease got the foul. That's her second. Seven different Rebels have scored. Nobody has more than 3 points. Karen Deaton hit an opening three-point shot to start the game. They have six other players with 2 points apiece. Peachin goes to the bench as Bishop has come off the bench and hit two free throws, trying to make it three. And LCC now within six. Shane is right back in, drives to the hoop. Jenna Kingsley wanted the ball, but it's stolen. Riddell has it. Drives to the basket, puts it up, draws the foul, and Lafayette Central Catholic right back to the free throw line.
A great strong move by Katie Riddell. She had a nice read on the skip pass as she gets the turnover and just takes it strong, because she knows that there is no way that Deaton is going to get in position. So at the very least, she's going to get fouled, which she did. Didn't make the bucket, but she's going to get a chance for the free throws. And you see great shooting form by Riddell. Her brother plays for Purdue, former Harrison Raider that walked on for the Purdue men's basketball team. Also a great shooter, found his way on the spot and actually gets some playing time and does a nice job hitting some three-pointers. So Katie gets it honestly.
Riddell made one of two, and Lafayette Central Catholic, even with the slow start, is just 5 points down here at the end of first quarter. LCC and South Central playing in the Class A state final, and it's South Central by 5, 15-10 on the Indiana Cable Network. Welcome back to Conseco Fieldhouse in Indianapolis, ready to start the second quarter of the Class A state final. South Central has a 15-10 lead over Lafayette Central Catholic. I'm Kristen Airy with Jane Schott, the third member of our team on the sidelines. Here's JMV.
Yeah, thank you very much, Kristen Airy. Obviously, LCC and their head coach, Jeff Salmon, preaching composure, control, and movement. And really, Randall Shane right now for South Central has a tempo game, with the exception of LCC hanging in, because as badly as they played in the first quarter, they're only down by five. So that's the good thing for LCC through quarter number one. Back to you, Chris.
All right, thanks, JMV. Lafayette Central Catholic inbounds the basketball as we start the second quarter here at Conseco Fieldhouse. South Central in the dark uniforms, Lafayette Central Catholic in the white. And a 5-second count called against the Knights. And that is the 10th turnover now against LCC. They're right, nearly right at their average for the year.
Yeah, that's a very big concern for their coaching staff. Katie Peachin looks very out of sorts right now. She can get settled down, it will help their offense so much.
And now South Central turns it over. That's their fourth turnover. Rachel Bishop off the bench has five now. And Lafayette Central Catholic within three at 15-12. Here's a long three. It's no good. Missed by Shane. And Lafayette Central Catholic now. A three-pointer would tie it up. They're also doing this with their leading scorer, Kathleen Mills, on the bench. She has two personal fouls. They look inside. Nice pass. It's missed. Rebounded. LCC gets it. But the missed shot by Bishop. And the Rebels have it. And a blocking foul is called on.
They got an offensive foul.
They called the offensive foul against South Central.
Well, and talked about Katie Peachin getting in rhythm. She passes it ahead to Rachel Bishop to get the easy bucket. Sometimes when things aren't going for you offensively, you got to find easy ways to get baskets. And that's what Central Catholic did on that last time down.
Candace Cartwright picks up the foul. That's her first. Our officials today, Don Corey, Bruce Klonowski, and Larry Simano. They have the opportunity, selected by the IHSAA, to officiate this Class A state championship game. And here we see the full court pressure. And now Riddell safely across the timeline. Bishop's shot is short. Shane has the rebound. And here comes South Central. They want to run quickly up the floor. Deaton. She opened the game with a three-point shot. Misses this time, but Shane, the offensive rebound.
Well, South Central not afraid to fire it up in transition, so they know that the rebound's coming off. Shane does a nice job of sliding on the weak side to get that missed shot, and so it's an easy basket. Lafayette Central Catholic has got to box out if they're going to stay in this game.
And then on the inbounds pass, LCC throws it away. Turnover number 11. Already, South Central has scored 13 points on those turnovers. They could add to that number right now. Pease is back on the floor. She has two personal fouls. Peachin made the steal. And a jump ball. Possessioner will belong to South Central. And I think for LCC to get back in, and they're only down by five, they've got to be more aggressive.
They do, and they're trying to make something happen on the defensive end. As you see Katie Peachin reaching from behind, making it happen, and then a great hustle play by both teams to get on the floor and try to get the basketball.
Jenna Kingsley has a field goal for two. She's playing off the bench. That's Valerie Burnett. There's a collision down low. Two players get tripped up. They're leg locked there. That could have been a 5-second call. Basketball will belong to Lafayette Central Catholic.
Brittany Shane got knocked down, and her and Grace Walker got tied up. Both players a little bit frustrated. Both sets of fans up on their feet wanting a foul call.
Sarah Beth Reed to the hoop, missed. Now South Central quickly up the floor, and Shane draws the foul and shoots free throws. Whether you miss it, make it, no matter what happens, South Central wants one pass up the floor.
Yeah, there is not a lot of patience on their offensive scheme, but that's what they're used to, Chris, so they know that they're going to push in transition, try to get a shot quickly, get the offensive rebound if they miss, and if nothing else, they rely on their defense.
76% free throw shooter Brittany Shane. A 5'5 sophomore. She had 25 last week in the semi-state win over Attica, 17 of them in the first half.
Yeah, she was, and that was from everywhere, like she's doing today. She finds a way to score for free throws, offensive putbacks. She can shoot the three, she'll penetrate. So she's got a complete game. You can tell she's a coach's daughter who grew up in the gym. She's a very fine player for a sophomore.
Jane, throughout this day, in all of our classes, we're going to see a lot of young players and an offensive rebound by Burnett. We're going to see a lot of sophomores, a lot of freshmen that have made an impact this year.
Yeah, this tournament dominated by young players, and there's some decent juniors and seniors, but there's a lot of sophomores, as you see Central Catholic can't get the basketball across the timeline, you know, in the 10 seconds. That is the pressure from South Central. And the other thing South Central's doing, they're getting on the offensive glass. As you see right there, Valerie Burnett off of a free throw. That's inexcusable to not block out on a free throw.
Now LCC makes the steal, but Grace Walker misses the layup. And now in transition, Deaton. Pease. And it's rebounded by Peachin. Lafayette Central Catholic now pushes the tempo. But they can't convert. They're shooting just 22% from the field. They're just 4 of 18 here. Long three by Shane.
A little quick on that shot. Yes, they are a transition team, but no rebounders. That's the big key. I think Randall Shane on the side was not happy with that shot selection because there were no offensive glass people that could get pulled down and miss. Right now, South Central has 6 offensive rebounds.
And here's a foul as Sarah Andrews goes to the basket. I think the one thing, and you indicated earlier, when we saw Lafayette Central Catholic in the half court able to run their offense, they were very effective. South Central's gotten them into this helter-skelter game that I'm not sure they want to play.
Yeah, it definitely is out of characteristic for them. I think South Central likes to play at this pace. They get out in the passing lanes. They're frantic. Probably the more frantic the game is, the better they play and the more shots they'll make. LCC, on the other hand, is not like that. They're a little bit more deliberate. They like to look inside. Kathleen Mills being on the bench for the most of this first half, I think, is really hurting them because it takes away that inside presence. Now the defenders from South Central can really get out and make it difficult for perimeter people from LCC to take care of the basketball. So her absence, I think, is a lot of why the Knights are having some trouble.
Sarah Andrews converts the free throw. She had attempted just 8 this year, made only 3, averaging less than a point a game. And a big free throw for Lafayette Central Catholic. Second one is no good. Rebounded and saved through her legs by Pease. And South Central has it. Shane now drives right to the basket, left side with a right hand, and Brittany Shane has 7.
Chris, she's pretty smart. She set that up because she actually had the basketball at the half court. Could have taken it herself, but gave it up. As you see Katie Peachin driving to the basket to get a layup herself. But she gave it up so that she could go down on the wing and receive the pass for the shot.
Deaton finds Orwick. Now Deaton. And they slow it down now with Pease.
South Central just being patient. If they don't have the transition, they'll run that flex offense. Lots of screening and cutting as you see it going inside. Not a good shot there. Just kind of threw it toward the basket, but still got the look.
Rebounded by Jenna Jones. Rachel Bishop gets the hoop and the foul. A 3-point play opportunity for Bishop, who now has 7 points off the bench.
Well, Rachel Bishop just running the floor. Right now, those 7 points, 4 of them have come from Katie Peachin pushing in transition. As you see Bishop going hard to the basket, did a nice job of concentrating, threw it up high off the glass, and absorbs the contact. So now she gets the chance for the old-fashioned 3-point play.
And they have a chance to cut the lead to 4. So Bishop already with 7. There you see her season numbers. She had 3 first quarter free throws. And 8 points now for Rachel Bishop, and the lead is just 4.
You know, the free throws could be a story down the stretch. Right now, Lafayette Central Catholic only 6 for 10 from the free throw line. They're getting opportunities. They're going to the line. South Central only 3 for 4.
Rebels have the ball. They have a 4-point lead. Warwick picked up her dribble. Now Deaton. Warwick in the lane. They go inside to Yelch. Yelch lost the ball. It's loose. Picked up by Lafayette Central Catholic and then thrown out of bounds on a good save by Riddell and a good hustling play by Grace Walker. And we have a timeout on the floor. South Central has led by 9. Right now they lead by just 4. Both teams hustling here in the Class A state final. South Central has led a couple of times by 9 here in the first half, and now Lafayette Central Catholic within 4. This is the Class A girls state finals in Indiana on the Indiana Cable Network. Kristen Airy, Jane Schott, JMV here at Conseco Fieldhouse. Tune in next Saturday, March 11th, for live coverage of the IHSAA Boys Regionals. I'll be joined by John Laskowski at Hinkle Fieldhouse. Check your local listings for the time in your area. Tonight, 64 sites across the state, the boys will crown sectional champions, the first rung toward moving to Conseco Fieldhouse here at the end of the month. Shane and South Central now add to the lead, and Brittany Shane has 9.
Nice move by Shane. The Knights did a nice job of sliding over and shutting off her lane to the basket, so she just pulled up with a little 10-foot jump shot.
Peachin drives on Shane right to the basket with a right hand, missed it. And Peachin nearly had the loose ball. Now South Central quickly up the floor. Kayla Orwick is there. And Deaton will fire for 3. They do not hesitate.
No, they don't. And you can see the offensive rebound starting to mount against the Knights. That was the 7th for the Rebels.
3 minutes to play in the second quarter. 6-point lead for South Central. Lafayette Central Catholic, a long 3. In and out by Jenna Jones. Jump ball belongs on the possession arrow to Lafayette Central Catholic. Let's take a look at the outstanding sophomore for South Central, Brittany Shane.
Well, you see the screen for Shane, and she splits that double team and tries to get to the basket. The help side came over, so she couldn't go all the way for the layup. She pulls it back and has a nice fadeaway jump shot. A very good shooter, offensive-minded. So Central Catholic has got to try to continue to keep the basketball out of her hands. If you watch Grace Walker play her, she's not even watching the basketball a lot of times. She's just watching Brittany Shane.
Another long 3, this time good by Jenna Jones. 47 of them on the year coming in.
Well, Jenna Jones has been a little bit cold, missed her first 2, but she got that one to go down.
Now Lafayette Central Catholic has the ball, a chance to tie with a 3. Rachel Bishop back on the floor. She had a breather. She scored 8 points off the bench for the Knights.
See the deliberate offense from Central Catholic. They go inside to Sarah Beth Reed, but she bobbles it, and another turnover for Central Catholic.
And here's Shane in transition, right to the hoop and scores.
And that's a nice move. She's a right-handed player. Tuck it hard with the left hand, with defense on her.
Got the friendly roll, did Sarah Beth Reed.
From a pass of Katie Peachin, her 3rd assist, all in transition today.
Shane misses again this time, and a foul is called on South Central on the rebound on Jenna Kingsley.
As we see, the bobble by Reed kicks it ahead for South Central, and you see Shane going with a little inside-out move, gets the defense off balance, and then Peachin brings it down hard where Sarah Beth Reed now gets the bounce and able to score in transition for the Knights.
Well, let's talk about Lafayette Central Catholic. They've done this again with Kathleen Mills, their senior 5'8 forward or center on the bench with 2 points and 2 fouls. Sarah Andrews, averaging less than a point a game, has 1. Sarah Beth Reed, averaging 2 points a game, has 4. And now Jones, it's the double bonus. She hits the free throw. So they've gotten good work out of Andrews and Reed off the bench.
They have, and you know, you got to credit their coaching staff for having confidence in their kids. A lot of coaches will put that kid back in. They'll put their leading scorer, Kathleen Mills, back in when they were behind. But Jeff Solomon stuck to his guns, and his post players, Andrews and Reed, are stepping up for him here this afternoon.
And despite committing 13 first half turnovers that the Rebels have tallied 15 points on, 1:57 to play in the second quarter, and the Knights trail by just 1.
You've got to feel like they've dodged a huge bullet there with being able to stay in the game.
Rebound batted around. We'll have a tie up in the lane as Sarah Yelch had two chances. But South Central has the ball on the possession arrow.
Frustration's getting a little high right now. There is a scrum on the floor as you see Sarah Beth Reed and Karen Deaton fighting hard for the ball. And Sarah Beth Reed had a little bit of a retaliation there and kicked Deaton in the head. And Deaton just gets up, and she's a tough kid. She didn't even flinch.
They go right inside of Yelch, and she's fouled. And the personal foul on Riddell. Katie Riddell has picked up her second. And free throws now for South Central. You talk about Lafayette Central Catholic. They started the year 0-5, 3-7, and 8 of their 10 losses are to 3A and 4A schools. I know Jane is a coach at Harrison up in West Lafayette, and you knocked off Lafayette Central Catholic. They played a very demanding schedule early on.
Yeah, and you know, Coach Solomon knew that he had a talented group. Confidence was low at the beginning. Obviously, when you start out 0-5, even though you're playing bigger schools, they felt like they could play with 3 and 4 teams, and they were struggling. But he stuck with it, tried to keep his confidence going with his team, and they've come through and had a very nice tournament run.
Beechin leads a 3-on-1 break, and Reed has the ball go right through her hands.
Ball just a little bit behind, but it's one of those situations where, you know, Katie Beechin breaks through the press, so she's under duress. And as a post player, if you touch it, you've got to get your hand on the basketball, particularly because, you know, Central Catholic having so many turnovers here in the first half, that's their 12th.
Bishop trying to pick up a loose ball. LCC gets it. Jenna Jones. Offensive rebound. Lafayette Central Catholic trailing by 2.
Play getting really ragged right now.
Reed can't get it. Rebounded by South Central and a foul. And the personal foul called on Grace Walker. She's a 5'10 sophomore.
That's her first. The play ragged, I think, favors South Central. But South Central almost is shooting themselves in the foot. Their shooting percentage right now down to 35%. They're 11 for 31. They have had many inside looks that they just are throwing at the basket and not getting it to go down. So that's allowed Central Catholic to get back into the game, even though they have experienced turnover problems.
Yeltz is 3 of 4 at the line, now make it 4 of 5. All of her points at the 15-foot stripe. She plays off the bench, a 5'8 junior. Had 3 points last week against Attica in the semi-state win. Left that short, and Jones got the rebound. Rebound totals are fairly even. The Rebels 22-21. 3-point lead for South Central. Shane guarding Jones. Peachin in the lane, lost it. Officially now 15 turnovers, and now a turnover by South Central.
Katie Peachin has 4 of those turnovers, and you know, she's a very good player. I've seen her play a lot. And this is definitely not characteristic of her to turn the ball over so much as the point guard.
Andrews into Jones, and a jumper by Grace Walker. And the game is a 1-point lead for South Central. And Shane goes right to the hoop, missed it, got her own rebound. Has the ball knocked away. It will belong to South Central with 10 and 8/10 seconds to play in the second quarter.
Brittany Shane very upset that she didn't get the foul call down low. The play is getting very physical right now, and players are just going to have to keep their heads and not let that affect their games.
Sarah Peace out front. They're looking for Shane. Shane will catch it and drive to the hoop. Cut off at the free throw line. Deaton at the buzzer for 3, just short. And the first 16 minutes are in the books at Conseco Fieldhouse. Brittany Shane leading South Central with 11 points. But LCC trails by 1. JMV standing by with Jeff Solman.
Yeah, thank you very much, Chris Denary. Well, you got a half your belt right now. It started not early first quarter, a lot of turnovers. How have you hung in?
It's just a matter of settling down. You know, we were juiced up when we come out. Couldn't even keep the kids out of the tunnel. We finally calmed down a little bit and got things going. We're still not playing very well. We need to pick up our intensity on defense, and we're not running any kind of offense, so we'll work on that at halftime.
I was at behind the huddle after the first time out. You were preaching movement, patience. Are you getting more of that in the second quarter than
it's
you were in the first?
A little better, but I still think we got a couple of kids that are scared to touch the ball, so we got to get over that and get this done this half.
Good luck in the second half. Chris, back to you.
All right, thanks, JMV. 28-27, South Central has a one-point lead at the half. We'll be right back with our halftime festivities at Conseco Fieldhouse on the Indiana Cable Network. Welcome back to Conseco Fieldhouse at the half of our Class A state final. South Central leads Lafayette Central Catholic 28-27. South Central has had the lead for much of the first half. They led by as many as 9, and LCC, Jane, despite all of their turnovers in the first half, Jeff Salmon has to feel very good about where his team is.
Most definitely. I think that, you know, that's uncharacteristic for this LCC team. So if they can keep it close with Kathleen Mills on the bench and all the turnovers, then they've got to feel good about their chances in the second half. On the flip side, Randy Shane has got to feel like missed an opportunity. They missed a lot of shots inside. His defense is doing what he wanted. It's really causing some problems on the offensive end, but they're not converting as much as they need to.
All right, we're going to take a look at our first half highlights here at Conseco Fieldhouse. Again, 28-27. It's a South Central one-point lead. We're going to look at Karen Deaton. She opened the ball game by hitting a long three for South Central. Now for Lafayette Central Catholic, they had a lot of turnovers, and Kayla Orwick made them pay. Valerie Burnett had a couple of hoops on offensive rebounds. For Lafayette Central Catholic, Rachel Bishop came off the bench and led them with 8 points. The leading scorer is Brittany Shane for South Central. She had 11 first-half points. Jenna Jones hit a big three for LCC, and that's where we are at the half. 28-27, South Central by one. We have more coming up at the half on the Indiana Cable Network. South Central has a one-point lead at the half over Lafayette Central Catholic. LCC has never led in this half. South Central led by as many as 9 the last time at 22-13, but right now it's just a one-point game. With Jane Schott, I'm Chris Denary, and turnovers the name of the game. South Central's pressure really made it tough on the Knights.
Yeah, we talked earlier, Central Catholic only averages 11 turnovers a game, and they already have 15 here in the first half, so that's going to be a topic of discussion. If they can settle down and take care of the basketball, that will help their offense. On the other side, though, I think, you know, South Central played a very good first quarter, jumped out to a big early lead, and really took advantage of those turnovers, but then had difficulty sustaining that lead. So now we've got a ball game.
All right, here we are, our Ball State University stats. Neither team shooting very well, both at 33%. South Central just 1 of 11 from three-point range. There you see the turnovers. Lafayette Central Catholic with 15, Jane. South Central scored 15 points on those turnovers.
Yeah, and they were doing that mostly from their full court pressure, and that was very good, and they got some offensive rebounds as well. So they're getting the easy baskets, but they have got to make sure that they continue to work their offense to get some looks and hopefully help their shooting percentage.
All right, Jeff Salmon will have to feel good that Kathleen Mills will be back on the floor. She was in foul trouble in the first half. 1-point lead for South Central on the Indiana Cable Network. Welcome back to Conseco Fieldhouse in Indianapolis, Class A State Finals. We have 16 minutes in the books. We've got the second half coming up, South Central 28 and Lafayette Central Catholic 27. Let's take a look at the leading scores. First of all, for Lafayette Central Catholic, Rachel Bishop got her 8 points off the bench in 12 minutes. She also added 2 rebounds and 2 assists. Jenna Jones had all 5 of her points in the second quarter. The leading scores for South Central, Brittany Shane has 11, Valerie Burnett has 4, and Sarah Yelch off the bench has 4, all of her points coming at the free throw line. All right, standing by is JMV. He is awaiting the head coach of the South Central Rebels, Randall Shane. I see JMV standing over there. The Rebels are out on the floor. You're looking down at Lafayette Central Catholic getting ready, and some of the fans here at Conseco Fieldhouse representing South Central. Very interesting outfits we have here at Conseco Fieldhouse this morning.
We do. They might have to get a look at one of the things that fans like to do. A lot of the cheering blocks will dress up, particularly those guys that are up in the front, as you see the prom queens from South Central. There's about four guys who have raided their sisters' closets and found dresses that sort of fit to get into the spirit for South Central.
All right, let's send it now courtside. JMV standing by with South Central head coach Randall Shane.
All right, coach, kind of a tale of two halves here. First quarter, you looked very good. I should say two quarters. First quarter looked very good, a little bit ragged in the second quarter. What happened?
I think they just they started throwing over top of our press there a little bit, and I think we got a little tired, and we just quit locating. I think we got satisfied in the first quarter, and we didn't come at them as hard in the second quarter.
What'd you tell your girls at halftime?
Well, we've always been a third quarter team. And this is what we have to do. I said, I don't think we played our best basketball, and we're still up one. So if we come out and play our best basketball, we can win this.
Good luck in the second half.
Thank you.
Chris Denary.
All right, thanks, JMB. Chris Denary, Jane Schott, our entire Indiana Cable Network crew. This is the first of four today. Hope you enjoy our telecast throughout the state of Indiana. Always two sides to look at it. If you're Randall Shane, that's the tack you have to take with your team. Hey, we're still up one, even though we had a nine-point lead. If you're just Jeff Salmon, you've never led in this game. You turn the ball over 15 times, and you trail by just one.
Well, and I think both coaches have got to feel like if their teams can settle down and shoot a better percentage in the second half, they'll be a lot happier. I think a lot of the missed shots were from rushing the shot and not settling down and taking good shots at the basket.
I think one thing that happened also for Lafayette Central Catholic is Katie Peachin, the point guard, settled down because she has a lot of pressure on her bringing the ball up against this South Central press.
Yeah, and now with Kathleen Mills back into the game, you'll see a different, I think, Central Catholic offense.
Knights have the ball to open the third quarter in the white uniforms. They trail by one.
And they run a quick hit right out of the break to try to get a look for either Kathleen Mills or Katie Peachin. They got Peachin going to the basket, but she just comes up short on the layup.
And Shane right to the basket, and a foul is called against Lafayette Central Catholic. It's on Katie Riddell.
Well, South Central does such a nice job of getting the basketball out quickly. They're doing a pretty good job on the defensive glass, making sure that Central Catholic does not get offensive rebounds. When they do, you better get back quickly. The Knights did not, and therefore you see Brittany Shane at the free throw line.
76% free throw shooter. She made 106 free throws this year coming in, so she can get to the basket. Foul on Riddell was her third. And now Rachel Bishop right off the bench. She played 12 of the 16 minutes in the first half and scored 8 points. And the lead is three for South Central, and they continue to press.
See how Kathleen Mills responds here. Kind of tough sitting for almost the first half completely. She might be a little cold. We'll see what she does.
There she is with the ball. Jones is going to fire a three. But it's rebounded by Peachin.
Peachin, a good athlete, quick to the basketball, handles the ball well, and sees the floor well. She's trying to get it to Mills, trying to get her, center, who's the leading scorer, involved in the offense. But right now, South Central's doing a nice job of covering that lane up. And that was one thing Coach Shane said, that they were going to not double on Mills, but try to cut down that passing lane.
Jones missed a three. And Jenna Jones had 5 points in the second quarter, hit a big three to pull them back within one. And now some full court pressure with Peachin out front guarding Sarah Pease.
Jones 1 for 6 on the afternoon, and she's a 40% shooter, so she's a little below her average right now.
Valerie Burnett pulls Mills out, near steal, but a three by Shane, and it bounces over the backboard. Well, Rachel Bishop was bailed out there. She went for the steal, and that gave Brittany Shane a wide open look at the top of the key.
Yeah, and I think Coach, her dad and her coach said, take the ball to the basket because you can get a really easy layup if you or draw defense and be able to kick it to someone.
And Peachin throws it away. That's another Lafayette Central Catholic turnover. And Jane, this would be one thing that LCC probably can't simulate in practice, this South Central full court pressure.
Yeah, they, and granted, the Knights play good defense, but South Central really just creates havoc. They get in the passing lanes, they're relatively athletic, they play hard, and it's difficult to simulate that. A lot of teams will use a guy's team to try to quicken the pace or whatever. I don't know if Central Catholic does that, but sometimes that helps.
Jones fires again.
Well, hey, Jenna Jones is a shooter. And if you're a shooter, if you've missed five out of your six shots, then that means the next one's probably going to go down, and that's what happened for Jenna Jones.
Shane to the basket, offensive foul. She dipped her right shoulder in. She's very effective getting to the hoop, and she threw it up with a left hand.
Well, and Jenna Jones, as I said, she comes off of a screen nicely, gets her feet set. When she gets her feet set, she's money, a very good shooter. She gets it to go down and have the Knights pull within one.
So Shane has whistled for her second foul, and it's just a one-point lead for South Central.
Both teams a little slow out of the locker room here. Not much scoring going on in the first couple of minutes.
What would it mean for LCC to take the lead? They do! Peachin gets right to the hoop, and LCC has its first lead.
Well, Katie Peachin, those are, you know, that's what she needs to do for this team. As she picks up the steal, she's going to get another opportunity. Coach Salmon is always trying to get her to be more aggressive on the offensive end. She runs their offense, as you see her do right there, get the ball to Jenna Jones, but Jones misses a three, and now you see Kathleen Mills. Her presence, I think, is going to be known here in the second half. She gets the offensive rebound there. There's Peachin taking it all the way down the lane. No help defense, so she got an uncontested left-handed layup for their first lead.
And South Central is going to take a timeout as Katie Peachin has given Lafayette Central Catholic its first lead of the game. So South Central takes the timeout, and I saw a brief smile on Katie Peachin's face because it has been a difficult morning and afternoon because of the pressure that South Central has put on the point guard in the backcourt. She has 6 points and five turnovers, but she gets the big hoop that gives LCC its first lead of the day. The IHSAA boys semifinals, you can watch those on Saturday, March 18th here on the Indiana Cable Network for live coverage of Semi-State Saturday. Check your local listings for the time in your area. We'll be on at either 1 or 3 o'clock. I'll be joined by John Laskowski. So we do it the right way in the state of Indiana. Laz, of course, an Indiana University grad. Jane, of course, a Purdue grad. So
that's right. Giving us
equal opportunity here on the Indiana Cable Network. I myself, I'm a Wabash grad, so I fit right in the middle.
We kind of take we'll take anybody, all the state schools. You do the radio for the Butlers,
right.
So everybody gets a little love.
Everybody gets a little love, right. Basketball will belong to South Central on the possession arrow.
Possession, South Central.
What would Randall Shane have been saying in that timeout, Jane?
Well, I think the biggest thing is, you know, defensively, they put so much pressure, but there was no help defense. He's got to be talking to his players about no uncontested layups, tightening that up on the offensive end. They just have looked out of sync. They're not necessarily a very patient team, but you see them here, they just ran their flex offense for about five or six passes, and they got a layup. They missed it again, but they did get a layup, and that's probably what Coach Shane was trying to get his team to do.
And Mills gets the rebound. Here comes Peachin. Bishop lost the ball, but got it back. Inside to Mills. Mills can't get it. Jones got it. And we have another jump ball.
And you see Kathleen Mills, she isn't getting double teamed, but South Central Rebels are close. They are close by, and right there, the coaching staff from LCC trying to tell their players, get out of the lane, give her a little bit of room, because if you're close by, then that means the defender can be close by, and that's why Mills could not get a handle on that pass inside.
I thought it was interesting. Jeff Salmon told GMB at the half that they hadn't run their offense, and he's right, because of the chaos that South Central has created.
Yeah, anytime you feel that pressure, you go down and make quick shots, and it just takes you out of rhythm.
Shane makes the steal on the inbounds pass. She has Peachin to beat. And she rims it out and can't get it in, and Mills has another rebound. Make that Jenna Jones.
Yep, Jenna Jones did a nice job of pulling down the rebound, but I think they are actually... They called it on Brittany Shane.
That's her third
foul. She's got to keep her head. She's very frustrated right now. If you look at her shooting percentage, she's 5 for 15, 0 for 4 from beyond the arc. But she's missed some layups that she usually knocks down. We've talked about her ability to get to the rim and get a layup. She does have 5 steals, so she's doing a nice job. But I think she's frustrated with her offense.
Katie Riddell is back on the floor. She has it, chased by three South Central Rebels. Look at that pressure and a walking violation.
Coach Stallman is very upset.
He is not real happy there. He thought there was some contact there. Jeff Stallman was an assistant on the 2003 Lafayette Central Catholic Boys State Championship team, so he knows what it's like to be in this building and win a state championship. He was a boys JV coach and assistant for 4 years, and boy, does he have it busy. He's a supervisor at Alcoa. He is finishing his student teaching at Purdue, and he's the husband and father of three. Foul in the lane. So you talk about a heavy calendar for Jeff Stallman, who is a graduate of Frontier High School.
He did say that he was looking forward. As you see Brittany Shane, nice move with the up and under. You see her splitting the defense, and she's so effective of that on the left hand. Did not get the basket because the foul was before the shot, but still a nice move.
Only two free throws in this quarter for South Central from Brittany Shane. Lafayette Central Catholic has a pair of field goals from Peachin and Jones, and now South Central throws it away again. So with 4:19 to play, 19 turnovers for Lafayette Central Catholic and 12 for South Central.
Well, both teams have come out of the halftime and turned it over. Continuing for Central Catholic, they have four here in the second half. South Central already has three here in the second half.
Peachin works against Shane. And now Riddell will fire a three and hit it. Her brother Bobby hit a couple at Mackey Arena on Wednesday against IU. That's a huge one for LCC.
Absolutely, and a nice setup by Katie Peachin. Katie Riddell gets her feet set. She is deadly. Great shooting form. You see her, she was standing at the top just waiting on it to come.
Shane fires a three, tries to match it, can't get it. And Riddell has the rebound for LCC. Peachin looked inside to Mills and fouled from behind by Sarah Yelch. So Lafayette Central Catholic has taken its first lead of the game here in the third quarter. And Katie Riddell hits the three. LCC leads by four. Lafayette Central Catholic has outscored South Central 7-2 in the third quarter. They have their first lead. They led 31-30. Then Katie Riddell hit a three to give them a four-point lead, and JMB is standing deep in the crowd along with the LCC fans. JMB?
Kristenary, I'm with the proud father right now. Katie Riddell's father is Bob, also the father of Bobby Riddell, the walk-on with the Purdue Boilermakers. Pretty thrilled with that three just a moment ago?
Absolutely. He's playing great.
Now, how are you keeping up with both son and daughter through all this?
Gas prices could be lower.
So what do you think is going to happen the rest of the game?
I think we've got a real good chance. Kathleen Mills is back in the second half, and we're playing our game. We've got a chance to win.
And your son Bobby hit two threes, and the Boilers lost at home the other night to IU. What do you think about their chances tomorrow?
Well, Ohio State's the best team in the conference, and they're going to give the Boilers all they want, but they'll play their hardest.
All right, thanks a lot. Chris Denary, a busy and proud father. Mr. Riddell.
All right, thanks, JMB. Gene Schott, who coaches at Harrison High School, the girls, and Bobby, of course, last year was a senior for Harrison.
Yeah, I got the pleasure to teach that young man. A great family, Katie doing a super job for the Knights, and you know, you just not like to see kids like that do well because they work hard. You know, they're good classroom kids as well, and a nice family, and it's nice to see Katie hit that big three for LCC.
And a foul as Mills got it. And even though Kathleen Mills has not scored in this quarter, Jane, she's still been a big factor.
Well, I think the presence of your leading scorer being on the floor makes a difference. And right now, you know, South Central has to worry about her. And the pressure's relieved a little bit on the outside, on the perimeter. We talked about that in the first half, really causing those turnovers.
There's Mills again, and Jones wide open. Rims out a three, but Mills right there for the rebound. Back up and in. Kathleen Mills, her first second-half field goal. All of a sudden, Lafayette Central Catholic by six.
Well, Kathleen Mills doing the right thing, kicking it out. But right there, another missed layup by South Central. I should have been keeping a tally. Boy, you know, when Coach Randall Shane looks like at this film, he is going to really have a hard time dealing with the missed shots. There's the miss by Jenna Jones, and Kathleen Mills muscles that rebound down and puts it up strong for the offensive putback.
And Shane misses. Jones gets the rebound. And she'll set it with Riddell, who gives the ball now to Peachin. Lafayette Central Catholic has a six-point lead.
See the ball movement, Riddell on the weak side, jumping up and down. She wants it, she feels it, and Katie Peachin gets her the basketball. That is Peachin's, sixth assist on the morning. And a big shot by Riddell, but then an answer.
Kayla Orwick answers back. And it's a six-point lead, 39-33 LCC.
We talked about Orwick stepping up her game in the tournament here. She's been pretty quiet. She's got a determined face, look on her face right now. I think she wants to help bring her team back.
Mills with a nice move down left of the basket draws the foul.
Well, you can see that reversal for the weak side there. The defense had gotten sucked over trying to stop Kathleen Mills. And Riddell picks up the benefit from it. But then Kayla Orwick, a very quick three on the other end off the penetration by Shane and a good assist by Shane. We talked about Peachin and her assist total, but Shane is also doing a nice job of distributing the basketball.
But Kayla Orwick will have to leave. She just hit the three. She has four personal fouls. Now Peachin on the inbounds. Too strong, but rebounded by Jones. And a foul down low, and now all of a sudden, you talk about South Central, they're aggressive, so they commit a lot of fouls, and right now it's really hurting them.
It is, and that's something where they were able to get through it in the first half. Kayla Orwick on the bench, you can see she is very upset that she has four fouls. She wants to be in this game. She's got to keep her composure because it's a long way from being over. You've got the entire fourth quarter. The Rebels, though, have got to be careful here now because they, besides that Kayla Orwick three, they only have free throws by Brittany Shane. So it has been a dry third quarter for them, and they found themselves in a six-point hole, and Central Catholic looking to build on that at the free throw line.
And Jones' free throw is good, and Lafayette Central Catholic is now in the bonus with 1:42 to play in the third quarter. Jones has 10 rebounds. 8 points, 10 rebounds. Now make it 9 points, 10 rebounds. She had 11.7 rebounds in the semi-state win at Plymouth against Argus. 8 point lead for Lafayette Central Catholic, and Shane, there's some contact underneath. The Rebel crowd not happy, but a traveling violation called on Brittany Shane.
Well, the official right in front of our broadcast spot turned and said she's out of control. I guess he was answering your plea about the contact. It wasn't really a plea. You were just stating,
I was just stating the
stating
fact.
What you saw.
And there's another fact as Riddell hits another three. It's an 11-point lead for Lafayette Central Catholic. We have a foul the other way, and Shane. And look at Katie Riddell. She had one free throw in the first half. That was early in the first quarter. She's now hit three threes, and they have opened up the game.
Well, in this third quarter, remember, South Central came out, had a couple of free throws from Shane, but since then, it has been all Central Catholic, and they have gone on a 17-3 run. And there's been a few three-pointers in there by the Knights to help that run.
Absolutely. Three by Riddell. She has nine in the quarter. Jenna Jones has four. Peachin gets into trouble. Now Shane trying to out-sprint Grace Walker and missed it. And rebounded by Kathleen Mills.
Where South Central has just gone cold here in this third quarter. They are 1-13 in the third quarter. The only field goal by Kayla Orwick, who sits on the bench with four fouls.
26% now they're shooting. And with 40 seconds to go, Mills right to the basket. Missed it. Rebounded by Burnett. Here comes South Central trying to get that lead into single digits. Deaton misses. And Peachin has the loose ball, flips it ahead to Bishop, who will coast in and lay it in.
Rachel Bishop has done a nice job off of the bench. Central Catholic had a little bit of foul trouble, so they had to go to Rachel Bishop, and she's come off the bench to score. 9 this afternoon, she's done a nice job.
Well, Jeff Solman must have had some words of wisdom in that locker room at the half, because his team has turned that Full court press at South Central played in the first half, now to their advantage. And there you see a fast break layup for Rachel Bishop, who off the bench today has 10.
Well, and you know, it's funny because Coach Shane said that his team was a third quarter team. This has got to be their worst third quarter of their season if they're a third quarter team.
Shot badly missed there by Justine Huffman, who is in for the first time. And I think Randall Shane now is looking at his bench. He has only 10 players. He has used them all here. And with 3 4/10 seconds to play in the quarter, they have one final shot to try to put some points on the board. And I don't think they're going to do it because Justine Huffman has no chance, and that will be it. Three quarters in the books and a huge quarter for Katie Riddell. She hits three threes, and Lafayette Central Catholic has a 13-point lead on the Indiana Cable Network. Lafayette Central Catholic outscores South Central 19-5 in the third quarter, and they've opened up a 13-point lead heading to the final 8 minutes in search of a state championship that would match the boys' 2003 state crown, and Jeff Solman would have his second state championship ring. He was an assistant on that boys' team, now trying to lead his ladies to this state title. A year ago, they were 11-12. They lost to Frontier in the sectional. Ironically, that's Jeff Solman's alma mater. Nice play by Riddell to make the steal. And now you can just see how things have flipped, Jane. I mean, South Central was the aggressive team. They had LCC on its heels, and now it's the other way around.
Well, and I think a lot of that has to do with South Central just struggling from the field. You know, you talked about that they only had 5 points in that third quarter. They just shot the ball miserably in that third quarter, going 1 for 15. And anytime that happens, you know, frustration runs high. You lose your confidence. You don't play as hard on the defensive end because you're not as aggressive. And on the opposite side, Central Catholic caught fire, and they're starting to play very confidently.
Kathleen Mills picked up her third foul. Here's Shane trying to get to the hoop, puts it up. Nowhere to go, and Mills has the rebound. We have a jump. It will belong to Lafayette Central Catholic, and the frustration continues for Brittany Shane, who's now 5 of 19 from the field. She has 13 points. She had 11 in the first half, had just 2 free throws in the third quarter.
Shane's got to be careful. Anytime a player, best player, as you see the steal there by Deaton, she's going to pick up a three. Maybe that will energize this Rebel team. But Shane was trying to do everything by herself, and her dad on the sideline said, kick it back out.
And the basketball will belong to Lafayette Central Catholic, and South Central trying to re-energize itself.
Well, that three from Deaton came off of a steal from their 1-2-1-1 full court press, and that's what they did in the first quarter to jump out to that big 11-2 run to start the game.
Peaching out front, 10-point lead for Lafayette Central Catholic. Riddell had 3 threes in the third quarter. She has 10 points. Mills to the basket. Nice move and a score for Kathleen Mills, who has 6.
Well, those threes really opened it up for Kathleen Mills because you've got to respect the outside shooting. That gives her a little bit of room to work, and she's able to take it to the basket.
Long three by Shane is perfect, and Brittany Shane had 65 of them coming in. That's her first today.
Well, I don't think the South Central team, they have not lost to a single A team this season, so they're not going to go away quietly, Chris.
48-39, LCC has a 9-point lead. Let's take a look at the last two hoops.
Well, we knew both teams were going to light it up, but we see Kathleen Mills taking it inside for a strong move to the basket there for the Knights. On the other side, Brittany Shane, a little step back three, gets it to go down. She struggled offensively, but if she could have a good fourth quarter, as she picks up a steal off of Peach, and she takes it in for a layup and gets that to go down as well.
And Shane now has 18. And South Central has cut the lead to 7 at 48-41. Jane, the one thing if you're Lafayette Central Catholic, still very important, you have to attack.
You do. You cannot play not to win, and that's something that teams get ahead, they relax a little bit.
Long three is missed by Grace Walker. Shane got the rebound, and here comes South Central. Knocked out of bounds. It was a tough shot there by Kayla Orwick, and they're going to give the ball to South Central.
You see Brittany Shane reading it very well to pick up that steal, stripping Katie Peachin, and then take it in for the uncontested layup.
6:11 to play. There is no shot clock in high school basketball, so I don't think South Central needs a shot clock. We talk about it in the first half. I mean, they're very quick. Lafayette Central Catholic with the lead can be a little bit more deliberate, but again, you made the point, Jane, you play to win, not to lose.
Yeah, you got to still play your game. The one thing we haven't mentioned, Chris, here at Conseco, Big Ten tournament's going on, so they still have the three-point arc. They've taped down a blue three-point arc for the high school games today, and Grace Walker was behind the red line, so she may have gotten a little confused and been a little too far out.
Shane misses, but Sarah Yelch gets the offensive rebound, and all of a sudden, South Central within five. 48-43, Lafayette Central Catholic. And a timeout, a 30-second timeout called by Jeff Solman.
Well, it's a good idea to get that timeout as he's getting after his kids to play intensely and to keep playing the way that they did in the third quarter to build that big lead. South Central, you know, maybe Coach Shane will say that they're a fourth quarter team. They've done more in the first couple minutes of the fourth quarter as you see Brittany Shane splitting the defense, missing it, but offensive rebound by Sarah Yelch. That's what you have to have. When you're struggling on the offensive end, you have got to pick up some offensive rebounds. And if you look, the South Central has been, they were doing it in the first half. They did not get as many second looks in the second half, but now they are at a point where they continue to get on the offensive glass, and they have to because of how poorly they're shooting the basketball.
They had just one field goal in the third quarter, a Kayla Orwick three. They've now hit four field goals here in the fourth quarter, a pair of threes, one by Karen Deaton and Brittany Shane's first of the afternoon. 5-point lead for Lafayette Central Catholic. Riddell now handling the ball at the point. 10-2 run right now by South Central. Mills.
Look how much attention Mills gets. She had three Rebel jerseys around her, which allowed Jenna Jones to get a rebound on the weak side.
Good save there by Jenna Kingsley. And here comes South Central. And Kingsley walks. Tried to set herself for that long three. Called for the traveling violation. 5:19 to play. And Lafayette Central Catholic has a 5-point lead.
Well, the Rebels have kind of gotten themselves back into this just with their defense, that transition. They turned it over, but that's what they need to do. Keep the pace up.
And what a move by Peachin.
Yeah, Peachin's trying to keep up as well. She's not going to go away quietly. She split the defense very nicely.
And Shane comes back the other way, and she draws the foul.
As you see Peachin there get past her defender, Brittany Shane, but slits the help side defense and able to put it in for a nice layup. On the other end, we see a similar thing as Brittany Shane takes the ball to the basket, and Jenna Jones, Kathleen Mills tried to take a charge, but they called her for the blocking foul, and that's her fourth foul. A lot of time left to play, so Mills has got to be careful.
And Shane, a very good free throw shooter. She now has 19. She is 4 of 5 at the free throw line.
25, Valerie.
Lafayette Central Catholic, 71% today at the line as a team at just 55%. There you see Shane's numbers. She's not far off a triple-double here today. And the rebound as she missed the second free throw. 6-point lead for Lafayette Central Catholic. Riddell. Boy, at the same spot, she had just made three of them. Now Jones.
Well, and then what happened, Chris, the defense came out on Katie a little bit quickly, so she reversed it, made the extra pass. That's good basketball right there, because then Jones had enough time to get the shot off.
And Kathleen Mills makes the steal. They tried to get her out, but Shane missed the free throw. Now South Central has it back, and the ball is knocked out of bounds right into the hands of my partner, James Schott.
Yeah, well, that was a nice pass, but unfortunately, I'm not wearing maroon, so I'm not sure Randall Shane would say that that's a good pass. And as you see right there, Jenna Jones with the three, big shot for Central Catholic. Central or South Central trying to come back and had cut it to six, but with that three, Central Catholic keeps them away.
5 of 13 behind the arc for Lafayette Central Catholic. Sarah Pease, here's a long three by Shane, got it again.
She loves the step back. Rachel Bishop looks over at Coach Solomon and shakes her head, kind of said, shrugged her shoulders and said, I was there, which is true, but Shane gets it off, and now she causes
the tie up. Yeah.
She almost got that steal.
And the basketball belongs to South Central. 4:15 to play. It's a six-point Lafayette Central Catholic lead.
Right there, as you see Brittany Shane with a little step back on the dribble. Rachel Bishop right out there, but she shoots over top. That steal by Shane will give her seven on the afternoon. You're right, she does have a nice line for a sophomore.
Well, she has 9 points here in the quarter. Here's another long three, in and out this time. And it's rebounded by Jones, and she's fouled. Lafayette Central Catholic's already in the bonus. And we'll walk the other way and shoot free throws for the Knights.
Well, free throw shooting is going to be big. That's the third foul on Jenna Jones. And I think if we look at the free throw shooting.
Yeah, Jenna Kingsley got the foul. Jenna Jones will be at the free throw line.
Jenna Kingsley gets the foul. Jenna Jones at the line. Free throw shooting for the Knights, 10 for 14. You remember, they were 6 for 10, so they have made their last four. And it's going to be a critical thing here in the fourth quarter.
And Jones has 13 points. She averages 8.5 points a game. Riddell has 10. She averages 7. So Kathleen Mills, their leading scorer, at nearly 13 points a game. She has to go out now with four personal fouls. She only has 6.
Well, a good move by Coach Solomon. Give Kathleen a little bit of a break. You know, and I think the scoring load has been picked up by the rest of the Central Catholic Knights. They're doing a good job of taking care of that.
55-47, 8-point lead. Deaton shot no good. And Shane right there puts in the offensive rebound. She has 24.
Brittany Shane, a very savvy basketball player.
And a holding foul is called on South Central, and Peachin will walk the other way and shoot free throws, and the foul is on Shane.
Brittany Shane.
And that's her fourth. They can ill afford to have her foul out, so Brittany Shane now has four. There's the offensive rebound by Shane, who now has 24 points, 7 rebounds, and 7 steals. So Peachin at the line, a 60% free throw shooter. She has 8 points.
Well, Shane has got to make sure she doesn't pick up her fifth, because if she goes out of the ball game with her team being down here in the fourth, very difficult for them to come back without her, I think.
Now, if Peachin hits this free throw, Lafayette Central Catholic will have four starters who average single digits on the year in double figures. And we have a timeout. 8-point lead for Lafayette Central Catholic, trying to win their first 1A state title here on the Indiana Cable Network. Lafayette Central Catholic holding on to an 8-point fourth quarter lead over South Central, 57-49. Of course, Lafayette Central Catholic located in Lafayette, Indiana, an enrollment of 227. South Central down in Elizabeth, Indiana, in Harrison County. They have an enrollment of 290. This is our Pizza Hut good stuff, and it's Katie Riddell with 3 threes in the third quarter. Gave them a 34-30 lead, a 39-30 lead, and their first double-figure lead at 44-33.
Very
and South Central,
point.
Yeah, Brittany Shane again scores. She has 26.
Yeah, Brittany Shane is trying to keep her team close, but I was going to say the threes by Riddell, they were very critical in that third quarter. They outscored the Rebels 19-5, and 9 of those points coming from Kayla Riddell.
And now the personal foul is on Kayla Orwick, and that will be her fifth. She'll leave with 5 points.
That's a big foul. Orwick, one of the three-point threats. She shoots 34% behind the arc, and she had a big one here this afternoon. So I think that's a big foul if they're going to try to come back. If South Central wants to come back here, they're down 6 with 3:40, so they're looking to get some quick baskets on the offensive end.
Kayla Orwick, a 5'3 junior, leads with 5. Now Peachin at the line, and free throw is good. They're in the double bonus now. Katie Peachin, again, if you're just tuning in, did not play last year as a sophomore. Coach Jeff Solomon encouraged her to sort of play over the summer, and she's had quite a year for them as the point guard. She had 14 points last week against Argus. She had 17 points in a regional semifinal against Lutheran. And now Shane right to the basket scores again. She has 28.
No help side defense. Shane just gets an uncontested left-handed layup.
Still plenty of time left, 3.5 minutes. Riddell being chased. Shane has to watch out. She's playing with four fouls.
South Central really applying that pressure, trying to trap from behind on the point guard, and a lot of pressure up top. A little bumping going on, but a no call.
Lafayette Central Catholic takes its time. Again, there's no shot clock in high school basketball. Grace Walker thought about that three. And Shane reaches in. And what is she thinking? Because that's her fifth foul.
A little bit of a sophomore mistake, Chris. I thought, you know, she struggled a little bit in the third quarter, but had a phenomenal fourth quarter. And you can see what kind of a player Brittany Shane is. Unfortunate that she's not going to be able to play these last 3 minutes, so you can see more of it. And she's visibly upset, and understandably so.
Trying to do it for her team, trying to make that steal, and she reaches in and commits the foul. And now Randall Shane will take a timeout. It will be a full timeout with 2:55 to play. So Brittany Shane fouls out with 28 points. Lafayette Central Catholic holding on to a 6-point lead. IHSAA championships are brought to you by Ball State University, the nation's number one wireless college campus. And by Indiana Farm Bureau Insurance, a proud sponsor of the IHSAA. South Central has seen its leading scorer foul out, Brittany Shane. The sensational 5'5 sophomore leads with 28 points. You saw her there on the left, but still plenty of time left with 2:55 to play. Kayla Orwick to the right, Shane to the left. Both have fouled out. Orwick with 5, Shane with 28. And Katie Riddell just missed the first of two. Two shots the rest of the way now for Lafayette Central Catholic there in the double bonus.
Well, right now, you know, Randall Shane takes a good timeout to try to gather his team and figure out how we're going to approach with two of their leading scorers on the bench.
And a traveling violation, Sarah Pease.
Well, and right there you see that's going to be the biggest problem. Not only are the two leading scorers, but they're also two ball handlers. So now Sarah Pease and Carrie Deaton are going to have to try to carry that load. And they have got to make sure that they play with confidence. You know, there's a lot of time, Chris, and they're down by 7, but it's going to be a tall tale for them to do, tall task, excuse me, to undertake without Shane on the floor.
She had 15 points here in the fourth quarter after making just 2 free throws in the third quarter. Rachel Bishop is fouled, and Rachel Bishop really played a key role in the first half for Lafayette Central Catholic. Kathleen Mills, their leading scorer, was on the bench with 2 points and 2 personal fouls, and Rachel Bishop had 8 points in the half and 5 in the second quarter that really kept Lafayette Central Catholic in the game.
Yeah, she did a great job of getting out in transition and got some easy baskets and also found herself to the free throw line. Although she misses this one, she was a big key to them staying in the ball game in the first half when they had so many turnovers.
Jenna Jones leaves. She has 14 points. Again, Kathleen Mills, their leading scorer, has just 6. Katie Peachin has 12. Riddell has 11. Jenna Jones, 14. And Rachel Bishop, 10. Their only double-figure scorer on the year, Mills, but 4 teammates in doubles today.
They stepped up their scoring when Mills went to the bench with 2 personals early in the first quarter.
That second free throw is good by Bishop. She has 11. The lead is 8. Nice hoop down low by Sarah Welch. She has 8.
Well, and a great pass by Pease. Good penetration. Here we see South Central coming with that full court pressure again. They foul. I don't think that was intentional. Coach Shane, she reached in. Anytime you reach with your hand and push down on the basketball, even if you get the ball, a lot of times the official's going to make the call. And I think that's what Coach Shane was talking to.
Well, they just have to stop the clock, whether they have to foul or not. They have got to stop the clock and then hope Lafayette Central Catholic misses free throws. And on the year, they're only a 55% free throw shooting team.
I agree, Chris, but I would say that Coach Shane's plan has to be try to get a steal in the backcourt, and once Central Catholic passes the half-court line, then you foul it, because it's only going to take off 10 seconds, and you might get a steal and a basket, which is much better than a foul and giving them opportunity to make a free throw.
Riddell misses the second. Lead is 7. Karen Deaton has a couple of threes, one in each half. And the ball stolen. Mills got it, and Bishop has the ball. Now they chase Bishop, and she has the ball stripped. No foul was called, and now South Central has a chance, and Riddell knocks it out of bounds. And the thing you have to do if you're LCC, you still have to be aggressive. Bishop sort of waited there, allowed the defense to come, and then they made the steal, and Randall Shane wants to talk it over and get a timeout with 1:56 to play. They're a three-point shot away, Jane, from cutting it to four.
They really are, and that's the thing. I mean, you know, obviously, with two players fouled out, I'm sure a lot of the fans from South Central might feel like the game is over and Central Catholic might be starting to celebrate. But there's a lot of time left on the clock that they've got to take care of the basketball.
Well, you're watching the girls today. You can watch the Indiana Cable Network on Saturday, March 25th, for live coverage of the IHSAA Boys State Championships here at Conseco Fieldhouse. Class A tips off at 10:30, followed by the 2A final game. The evening session begins with a 3A game at 6, followed by the 4A state championship game. Will it be Greg Oden, Mike Conley, and Lawrence North in the state championship game for a third consecutive year? Odds would say yes. They are not just one of the best teams in the state. Sports Illustrated has them ranked number one in the country, and a foul by Sarah Yelch. And you talk about Lawrence North's boys being ranked number one in the country. Later tonight in the Class 4A final, we'll see South Bend Washington at 25-1. Sports Illustrated has them ranked number seven in the country.
They're a very good basketball team. And we're going to talk more about some of the key players to that game, but Skylar Diggins from South Bend Washington, and there's a buzz about her in Indiana.
She's just a freshman.
So that'll be fun to, so stay tuned. Make sure you don't go too far and check that out later tonight.
Kathleen Mills fouls out with 6 points and Welch at the line.
Sarah Yelch at the free throw line.
9 points now for Welch.
I was going to say, Sarah Yelch has done a nice job. She's scored on the inside. South Central doesn't have a big post presence, but she's come up with some free throws today. 5 for 7 from the free throw line, 7 rebounds, and a couple of field goals to go along with it.
And a double-figure effort for Yelch off the bench. She has 10. She's a junior. She'll be back again next year. And 4 Rebels over there to foul Katie Peachin. It was by committee. They'll only get one foul there.
Foul's on number 14.
And the foul is on Karen Deaton. When you look at South Central and you look at their starting lineup, they have two seniors in Burnett and Peach, but a sophomore in Shane. Deaton and Orwick are juniors, and Yelch is also a junior.
And they will be back because while they have a fine senior class, South Central, the majority of their scoring is returning next year, so you would expect them to be able to make another run in the tournament. On the other side, Central Catholic, half of their team is seniors, and that's part of been part of their success. Their athletic teams have done well this year because of the senior class.
Well, free throw is good by Peachin, 14 points. And the lead is 7.
Peachin has yet to miss a free throw today.
Long three by Kingsley, her 16th of the year. And all of a sudden, it's just a 4-point game. And Riddell is fouled. And again, it becomes a free throw shooting game now for Lafayette Central Catholic.
Well, when you look down the Central Catholic, that three, first of all, by Kingsley, a big shot. Pease penetrates, kicks it out. The people that are stepping in off the bench for Shane and Orwick are doing a nice job keeping South Central close and giving them a chance.
And look at the free throws now for Lafayette Central Catholic. 76% for Coach Jeff Salmon. They are 22 of 29. And Riddell pops home another one. She has 14.
Well, remember, they've hit 17 of their last 20.
3-point shot missed, but rebounded by Pease. And another long three, and it's good. Candace Cartwright. And the lead is just 3.
This game is not over, Chris. Even though Central Catholic continues to make free throws, they're only getting 2. And on the other end, South Central is picking up 3s. Randall Shane puts in his 3-point shooting team. As you see, Pease gets the rebound. She penetrates, kicks it out.
And Cartwright.
Candace Cartwright off the bench does not get as much playing time. She averages 3 points a game. She knocked down a big shot for the Rebels here late in the game.
And now Peachin at the line. 15 points now for Katie Peachin. There you see the Lafayette Central Catholic bench, and Peachin, look at the free throw differential, and the main reason is South Central forcing LCC to the line, and 16 now for Peachin. The lead is 5. 68-63, Kingsley is called for the walking violation. Good defense there by Rebecca Gloyeski, who's in for the first time for Lafayette Central Catholic. And she gets her first state championship taste, and right back in is Jenna Jones.
Coach Jeff Salmon giving somebody an opportunity to step on the floor, but with the game being so close, he needs someone like Jenna Jones in the game. Heady player, can take care of the pressure.
And Peachin lost it.
Little bit of a hurry there by Katie Peachin. A lot of times players will try to get away from the pressure by catching and going down the floor quickly. That's what Peachin did. She needs to just catch and square up and relax. I think Coach Salmon is actually doing offense defense substitution, because we see Jenna Jones go right back out. She sits in the number one spot there. She's probably going to go back in on the offensive end.
Lafayette Central Catholic, 27 turnovers, yet they have a 5-point lead. South Central needs to score quickly. Pease to the hoop, scores, and a foul. Sarah Pease has a chance for a 3-point play. And all of a sudden, the Rebels within three could crawl within two.
Well, Sarah Pease being face guarded by Grace Walker. The only way to relieve that pressure is to go back door. As you see her there, that's how she picked up the basket, took it strong to the basket. Sarah Andrews trying to come over and help side defense, fouls her on the shot going in. And now the Rebels have a chance to cut it to one.
It was a 13-point lead after three quarters for Lafayette Central Catholic. Rims out, no good. Rebound by Walker. And Grace Walker is fouled. And now Grace Walker goes to the free throw line to shoot two. Has attempted just 8 free throws this year.
Fouls on number 30, Sarah.
And Sarah Pease is fouled out. So that's her 5th personal foul. She leaves with 4 points. And
Chris, that's a big foul for South Central. Not that they all haven't been, but you know, Sarah Pease, I thought, was the main person that brought them back, even though when you look at her stats, she didn't score all the points, but she got some assists that set people up.
And the free throw in and out, no good by Walker.
Grace Walker, a defensive stopper for this Central Catholic Knights. Difficult task to step up and hit some pressure free throws. It's gotten tight now.
She's just a sophomore.
She
and it's now a 2-possession lead. 4-point lead for Lafayette Central Catholic. And the Rebels throw it away.
Well, you see Justine Huffman now taking over the point guard responsibilities, and so that is a difficult thing. Sarah Pease out of the game, and now Huffman's got to try to run the offense, and she got a little hurried there.
And the Rebels call a timeout. We'll be right back. LCC by 4, 69-65 on the Indiana Cable Network. Lafayette Central Catholic leads at 69-65. There you see the South Central fans hoping that their Rebels can come back. Kristen Ari and Jane Schott along with JMV here at Conseco Fieldhouse. This is our Farm Bureau game recap. Brittany Shane, 28 points, but she's on the bench. She is fouled out. Lafayette Central Catholic has had 8 players score. They have 4 in double figures. That despite their leading scorer, Kathleen Mills, with just 6 points. And Peachin is tripped up and fouled. And it's become a free throw shooting contest for Lafayette Central Catholic. They are 26 of 34 in this game. They've done a really nice job at the line.
Yeah, and it's been an interesting game for Central Catholic. Definitely not the way they have gotten to this state finals. They've been so good all year long at taking care of the basketball, averaging 11 turnovers. They've got 25 today, and their free throw shooting has been outstanding, as you see Katie Peachin hit another one, 27 for 35 on the season as a team. They are only a 55% free throw shooting team.
14 points in the quarter from the line, and Peachin is perfect in this quarter, 10 of 10. And the lead is 6 at 71-65. 35 seconds to play. LCC trying to win a state title, and here's a foul. And South Central gets exactly what they wanted. The clock stopped, and free throws with Jenna Kingsley.
might be a little bit too late, but still 30 seconds left. Kingsley needs to hit both of these free throws to keep it close and probably expect that full court press again from the Rebels. If they can't get a steal, they're going to foul again.
And Kingsley drops it home, and this is where the college rule would help. When on a made basket, if South Central can score, the clock would stop, but not so in high school basketball. Here's the second from Kingsley. Rims out, rebounded by Jones. Walker got it, wrapped up by Jenna Kingsley, and she'll have her fourth foul. South Central now with 30 fouls in this game, but many of those are here in this quarter because they wanted to foul. They had to sort of elongate the game, make it last a long time. Well, I said it was her fourth, it's her fifth, and she becomes the fourth Rebel to foul out.
Well, and really, Chris, that game plan was working for a while. That's what got them back in the basketball game. They were down by six, and remember, they were able to cut it to three because they were fouling. Central Catholic was getting 2 points on the free throws, and then they had three threes that kept them court, that allowed them to cut it to three instead of that six-point lead. But unfortunately for the Rebels, as more people foul out, I think
Kayla Money is in for the first time, a 5'9 sophomore, her first appearance. And now Katie Riddell is at the line for Lafayette Central Catholic. There you see her numbers. 30 3/10 seconds to play. And the lead is six. And they have done the job at the free throw line. 7-point lead. Deaton misses, rebound tipped out. South Central gets it back, but they're running out of time with Huffman. Long three by Deaton. No good, rebounded by Peachin. Wrapped up by Huffman. And I would say Lafayette Central Catholic is going to win the Class A state championship with 15 seconds to play. A team that trailed by as many as nine in the first half and could not handle South Central's full court pressure. But the tide turned in the third quarter.
Okay, Peachin with two shots.
And really, it's been the backcourt of Peachin and Riddell. Free throw bounces out by Peachin.
That's her first miss of the day.
She had made 10 straight. And you'd have to think that she has to like her decision to play basketball this year.
As does the Central Catholic community. Just a really nice player. Plays hard, understands the game extremely well. When you look at her line today, 8 rebounds. She leads this team in rebounding as a point guard. And she has 11 for 12 from the free throw line, 4 assists, and 19 points.
And Lafayette Central Catholic's been able to get everybody in. Rebounded by Peachin. She'll be fouled again. Now with 9 9/10 seconds to play, she'll walk the other way. Andrea Cochert is in for the first time. And so, and also Allison Roberts is in. So everybody on both teams has an opportunity. And there you see the very happy Lafayette Central Catholic bench as Peachin will again shoot free throws.
You know, somebody we haven't mentioned from Central Catholic, Megan Reisinger, an assistant for the Knights. Her father is about to be on stage here in the 2A game. Rick Reisinger is the head coach of Heritage Christian, so kind of a family affair today.
Shot is no good. This should be the final seconds. And the basket is good by Justine Huffman, but Lafayette Central Catholic has won the 2006 Class A state title. They knock off South Central 75-68. Jeff Solomon was an assistant with the LCC boys when they won a state title, and there you see a very happy Jeff Solomon with one of his assistants. And a big win today for the Knights of Lafayette Central Catholic.
Well, it was, and a great performance by his team. Obviously, they struggled in the first half, but did a nice job of adjusting and taking care of things. And they really played hard. South Central played hard as well, but just came up short, didn't shoot the basketball very well, and Central Catholic hung tough.
Lafayette Central Catholic scores 48 points in the second half, and they knock off South Central 75-68. They're your 2006 Class A state champs. Welcome back. Lafayette Central Catholic has won the Class A state championship in Indiana, 75-68 over South Central. Let's head to our public address announcer, Scott Gregg, with the announcement of our Mental Attitude Award winner.
For his generous support of our student athletes. After we announce the name of the recipient, we invite her parents to join her on the arena floor. The recipient of this award, while a student in grade 12, was nominated by the principal and coach, excelled in mental attitude, athletic ability, scholarship, and leadership during the 4 years of high school, participated as a state finalist in this sport, and was selected by members of the IHSAA Executive Committee. The winner of the 2006 Patricia L. Roy Mental Attitude Award for Class A Girls Basketball is Sarah Pease of South Central High School.
Sarah Pease of South Central is our Mental Attitude Award winner. I know a disappointing morning and afternoon for the South Central Rebels, but Jane, Sarah, a very deserving winner of the Patricia Roy Mental Attitude Award.
Well, she's a versatile athlete. She participates in cross country, track, and cheerleading. She does seem to do it all for South Central. Her GPA is 3.87, and it just seems to be like a great kid, and you're really happy for her. I know she's probably very disappointed that her team lost, but a nice consolation for her and her parents.
She is the daughter of Jeff and Jacqueline Pease, plans to study exercise science and sports communications at Indiana University. Indiana Farm Bureau Insurance has presented South Central High School with a $1,000 scholarship in the name of Sarah Pease. It goes to the school's general scholarship fund.
2006 Class A State South Central Rebels. Making the presentation on behalf of the Indiana High School Athletic Association, Randy Barrett of Eastern Green, assisted by Nancy Alsball of Manchester. Also, Student Advisory Committee members Brant Jackson of Evansville North and Tia Benoit of Mount Vernon, Fortville. First to Kayla Money. Karen Deaton. Candace Cartwright. Jenna Kingsley. Justine Hoffman. Valerie Burnett. Sarah Pease. Kayla Orwell. Brittany Shane. Sarah Gelch. Student Manager Daniel Bottles. Assistant Coach David Ringer. Assistant Coach Chad Shane. Your head coach, Randall Shane. Assistant Athletic Director, Rick Yule.
Hey, Rick.
Athletic Director, Keith Marshall. And Principal, Jim Crisp. Now, ladies and gentlemen, the presentation of the runner-up trophy and game ball to be made by Executive Committee member Mr. Lee Alonzo, Carmel High School, to your 2006 Class A state runner-up, South Central.
South Central, the Class A state runner-up in Class 1A. Randall Shane. The Rebels finished 23-6. As Lafayette Central Catholic gets the 7-point Class A state championship win. 28-27, South Central had the lead at the half. Lafayette Central never led in the first half, but they used Katie Riddell's three third quarter threes on the way to a 19-5 run in the third quarter. They were outscored by South Central 35-29 in the fourth quarter, but Central Catholic does it at the free throw line. Lafayette Central Catholic, tremendous job of shooting free throws. They were 32 of 42, and here is the medal presentation for the Class A state champ, Lafayette Central Catholic.
Rachel Bishop. Kathleen Mills. Sarah Beth Reed. Sarah Andrews. Andrea Coker. Katie Peachin. Allison Roberts. Grace Walker. Rebecca Loyasi. Assistant coach Megan Reisner. Assistant coach Marcus Ranger. Assistant coach Chad Arnold.
Well, you heard Megan Reisinger's name. She is the daughter of Heritage Christian head coach Rick Reisinger. And Jane Schott, she also was a member of a state championship team back in 2002 at Terre Haute South, 4A state champs.
Yeah, there's a lot of good basketball blood in their family. Rick played for Purdue. Megan had a great high school career as well. So kind of fun to see them down here on the same day in the 1A, 2A. They get to enjoy the morning together.
And daughter Courtney is a member of the staff at Heritage Christian. She was also an Indiana All-Star back in 1998. So what a day, and I'm sure it would be complete for that family if Heritage Christian could win the 2A state title.
Well, that's coming up next. Stay tuned, but right now we've got Lafayette Central Catholic celebrating their first ever state championship in girls athletics and in basketball as well.
So Lafayette Central Catholic, the 2006 Class A state champs. We'll be back to talk to the winners and our Mental Attitude Award winner. The Knights win it 75-68 over South Central here on the Indiana Cable Network. Lafayette Central Catholic is the Class A state champion in Indiana in 2006. They beat South Central 75-68 with Jane Schott. I'm Chris Denary. Let's send it courtside. JMV is standing by with our Mental Attitude Award winner.
Yeah, thank you very much, Chris Denary. I'm with Sarah Pease, also with her head coach, Randall Shane. First, Sarah, I know it's not the award ultimately you wanted, but you guys gave it great effort, especially down the stretch, especially when your high score, the sophomore, had fouled out. How do you feel ultimately about the experience?
It's been a great experience. I mean, our teammates, we've given each other everything we could give, and our coaches have given us everything we could give. It's just unfortunate it turned out the way it did.
When you started this season, Sarah, did you ever have dreamed that you would end up on the floor at Conseco Fieldhouse?
Not especially, but I knew we could do it, and we ended up here, which is a great accomplishment that we're very proud of.
Well, congratulations on a great season, Sarah. Thank you very much. Let me bring in the head coach. Randall Shane is with us now. We talked at the half regarding what you had to do in the second half, and ultimately the third quarter probably was your undoing, but you really have to be happy with the way your girls hung in.
I am really. I'm really proud of them. And that's, you know, the third quarter has been kind of our strong point all year, and I thought Lafayette Catholic did a good job of not letting us get our run. Instead, they made their run, and we didn't react to it very well. But the girls, I thought, responded back to it in the fourth quarter, and you know, we cut it down to where we needed it at, and I had maybe a couple key players not fouled out. Maybe we could have made a little difference.
Let's talk about one of those, your daughter Brittany, with 3 minutes and some change left on the clock. That was probably the play of the game.
Yeah, it was, really. And, you know, we need her on the floor. And, you know, for her to go out that early and probably to pick up a foul at midcourt like she did, you know. But she's a sophomore, and sometimes I forget about that, you know. And hopefully, you know, she'll learn from this and we'll move on.
How do you like this coaching thing in the state finals, by the way?
This is neat. I'd like to try to do this more often.
It is your first attempt to get, I should say, your first appearance up here for the school. I'm sure this is something you'd like to do and try again the next couple of years with your daughter at the helm.
I would, and I really feel like, you know, we've got a great shot at it. You know, we beat some good teams along the way. We'll have to go through some of those again next year, but I feel like, you know, we got a good chance to maybe make it back.
Coach, we'll look for you next year, hopefully. Thanks for the time.
All right, thank you.
Chris Denary.
All right, thanks, JMB. 75-68, Lafayette Central Catholic gets the 1A state title. Highlights and stats coming up next on the Indiana Cable Network. All right, the first of four games complete today. The 1A state championship game in Lafayette Central Catholic beat South Central 75-68 with Jane Schott. I'm Chris Denary. A tremendous comeback by Lafayette Central Catholic. They outscore South Central 19-5 in the third quarter, take their first lead of the game, and Jane never give it up.
Well, it was a great third quarter by the Knights, and they really did it with from beyond the arc. Kathleen Mills got in foul trouble in the first half, but she responded in the second half, and they was able to kick it out to those three-point shooters. Katie Riddell, Katie Peachin came down in the stretch, and I thought Central Catholic really did a nice job the entire morning.
And they also hit 24 of 30 from the free throw line in the second half. Big fourth quarter free throws. Everybody hit them down the stretch, and that gives them a seven-point lead. Let's take a look at the highlights of our 1A state championship game here in Indiana. LCC gets the seven-point win.
Karen Deaton hits that big three for South Central, but Central, I mean, that was a lot of because they were putting so much pressure on in the first half. We see the off of the turnover and then also off of the missed basket there, but Central Catholic rallied back. Rachel Bishop comes in off the bench, does a nice job of taking it to the basket. Leading scorer today for South Central, Brittany Shane, hits a 10-footer. But behind the arc, the Knights own the three-point range. Jenna Jones with the big three there. Katie Peachin was a big factor all morning long. She takes it hard to the basket for the layup. And then she dishes to Katie Riddell for a big three. Her 9 points in the third quarter turn the tide of this game. There's another one of those threes.
That layup you saw by Peachin gave them the lead for good. Then Riddell got them out to a 13-point lead. But Brittany Shane would try to bring South Central back. She hit the long three, then the steal. And South Central was coming back from a 13-point deficit. But down the stretch, Peachin would hit again. Shane would foul out. And then Jones would hit another three. And Lafayette Central wins the state title. For head coach Jeff Salmon, 75-68. They won a state title for the boys in 2003. They had a state championship for the girls here in 2006. So Lafayette Central Catholic gets the title. Jeff Salmon tasted it as an assistant coach, and now as the head guy, he gets another one.
Yeah, he has got to be so proud of his team. They started out 0-5, Chris, and I know if you would have asked him at that point in the season, do you think you can win a state championship, he probably would have laughed. But he believed in his kids, and his kids believed in him, and they did a great job of coming back and getting better each and every game. Their defense held them through all the whole season, and they played outstanding today. Even though it wasn't the prettiest game for them, they hung in there, and I thought that they played a nice game. So hats off to Jeff Salmon and the Central Catholic Knights.
All right, let's take a look at the final game stats today here at Conseco Fieldhouse in our Class A state championship game. Lafayette Central Catholic, yeah, they had 27 turnovers, but look at the free throws, 32 of 42. We told you in the second half, 24 of 30. That was a huge stat, Jane, because South Central put them on the line and Lafayette Central Catholic answered.
Well, and they had a lot foul out as well.